Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokémon Sun Blind Nuzlocke. Now, just so you guys know, the first seven episodes, I think it's episode eight. The first seven or however many episodes have been happened before this, those were all recorded on one day, all in a row. So this is one day later. So since it has been one day since I actually played last, I've had a lot of time to think about some things. I guess I'll start walking this way while I talk about this stuff. First of all, I was thinking about Z-moves, and I was like, you know, Z-moves actually seem like this really powerful thing, kind of like Mega Evolution. Should I even allow them in this Nuzlocke? First of the type of Pokemon, yes I do. But anyway, because like, in my Y Sleeplock, I used Mega Evolution, and some people didn't like that, and then every time I played X or Y after that, in like playthroughs on streams, I never used Mega Evolution, because it was kind of overpowered. Oh yeah, I did training, everyone's level 15. Because I wanted to make sure we were good to go. We're not going to have much time to train. As time goes on, so. And, we learned Fire Fang. So, wow, I was pretty good. Nice job, Stu. Alright, So I wasn't sure though. I didn't really know enough about Z moves to make the decision should they be banned from this Nuzlocke. So I went to my Twitter. So I asked. So guys, without spoiling anything, could you tell me if Z moves should be banned in a Nuzlocke? Pretty much the unanimous opinion was no, don't ban them. They're actually pretty balanced. And a lot of trainers in the game actually use them. It's a lot more common than Mega Evolutions were, for example, in X, Y, and Oras. So, well, alright then. So guys, if you wanted to interject your opinion on that thing, well, you need to be you should have been following me on Twitter when I asked this question, which was like November 21st or 22nd. So that's how you know. That's just so we know when this was recorded or when the first episode was recorded. Oh, there's a cave here. Where are we supposed to? Are we supposed to go here? Meme Meadow. Okay. And no, this doesn't look like a cave. It was just an archway. Okay, whatever. Hey, it's Lily. So yeah, I'm gonna be using Z moves. Nebby, come back. Nebby, come back. Aqua 11. Nebby, you're out of the meadow here. Lily, really? He's right over there! Can you really not see him? And right after, he got so much trouble on the bridge too. What if a wild Pokemon attacks? It doesn't have any moves we can use to battle. Wow, what a sucky Pokemon. Why would you want to save it? Oh, so it's like a legendary that only knows Splash or something? That's kind of funny. All right, we got a Great Ball. That's great. Well, this is a new area, isn't it? This is a something meadow, right? This is, yeah, Meme Meadow. Let's catch something in Meme Meadow. It is! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Pretty flowers. Oricorio? That's what an Oricorio is! There was a guy talking about those. Wow! So it's a new bird thing. I have absolutely no idea what type that is, or what it even is or does. I'm gonna guess it's part flying. It looks like a flying something. Flying grass, or flying fairy, maybe? I'm gonna give it a quick little scratch. That should be okay, right? Right? Yeah. Oh, that was a critical hit. Okay. Alright, I'm actually gonna throw balls now. Because I'm kind of afraid of killing it. Let's throw a nest ball. It probably won't work, but we'll just try all our balls. Try all the balls! Another thing I was thinking, I'll wait till I catch this first, before I start talking about that stuff more. Yay, we got an Oricorio! Yes, another new Pokemon! Thank goodness. I'm sick of catching old stuff. So, alright, I know absolutely nothing about this thing. It looks like a cheerleading bird. That looks pretty cool. Wait, does it not evolve? Yeah, there's no, like, slot before or after it. That's interesting. Sorokyo has sipped bright yellow nectar. Its bright cheer dance melts the hearts of its enemies. Oh, it makes... Oh, it's electric flying! Oh, nice. Nice. That's really cool. All right, Oricorio, what should I name you? This is Simmer. Simmer kind of sounds like a girl name, like Summer. I don't know. Where do you want to send Simmer to? I love that I can just pick where I want it, but still, I'm going to send to a box because going to be a little bit of an unwritten rule that I'm not going to swap out team members unless someone dies. So it's not like I'm kicking them out because I don't want to use them anymore. So let me show you guys the rest of my updated team. Everyone is 15. The biggest difference is Roast, who evolved into a Pokemon called Trumbeak. So this is the first evolution I've had in Sun and Moon. And the evolution animation looks really freaking cool in this game. But anyway, I was wrong. It's not fighting flying, but it still learned Brick Break somehow. Well, maybe its final evolution is fighting flying. Who knows? We got Microwave is about the same. Rotisserie is about the same. Steam is pretty much everyone's the same, let's be honest now. Oh, you learned Nightshade. That's a little bit better than Lick. Let's put that up front. At least I think it's better than Lick because you have lowered physical attack. But something else I was thinking about between the episodes is, remember when we fought Illima and he was like, wow, you beat me. You totally could beat my challenge. And I was all mad. Oh, Akadne, I would have been happy with that, but a lot less happy than I would have in Oricorio. So thank you for letting me have Oricorio game. He was like, you can beat my challenge. And I was all mad that, hey, I beat you. I should get your thing. Well, that was a false assumption on my part. I was assuming you actually battle the captain in their trial at some point. That was proven to be incorrect when I actually did his trial. Because no, the boss of his trial was just a gumshoes. My girlfriend always disappears somewhere. Wow. That sucks, man. I know what you mean, though. Hey, Cosmog. Or Nebby, whatever you want to be called. Pew, pew! So yeah, I was mistaken to think that, but hey, So really, he wasn't even trying to run away, he was just standing over there. What was the point of this cutscene? Wait, what did you just do? Did you heal my team? They weren't that hurt, but thanks. Held Oricorio changes appearance by feeding on nectar from different- Oh, so it's like the Flabébé of this generation. It looks different depending on the flower patch. A form change. That's really cool. So, wow, just like my first Y Nuzlocke, I got a yellow Flabébé. Now I got a yellow Oricorio. That's kind of funny. So that's interesting. I wonder if it changes type, because electric flying, it's a yellow. Yellow is usually the color for electric. So I wonder if it changes type when it changes, flower color. Oh! How? I did not say I wanted to battle! That's really, I'm glad Lily healed me. He only has two Pokemon still. Are you kidding me? Okay, I gotta be honest. Here's the other thing I was thinking about. I haven't had a single death yet, and I know telling you guys that, saying this now, is completely jinxing it. Believe me, I've played enough Nuzlocke to know how this works, but seriously, I don't feel like I'm being challenged. Well, I gotta be honest, though, there were some battles where I feel like I got pretty lucky. Like, for example, that teacher I fought in the school with the Dark Meowth, I feel like if I had flinched just once against that Meowth, I would have lost that battle. I only had two Pokemon at that point. I could have lost the Nuzlocke right there. But I didn't. But I'm thinking of switching because I know he has Rowlet as his other Pokemon, so I kind of wanted to save. Oh, but then at the same time, I could always use Roast. So yeah, Stu, you're fine. But I am going to use Ember because Pikachu is static. I don't want you to get paralyzed. And he's even lowering my physical attack anyway. So, also, I could be wrong, but I just have a strong feeling that Stu will be a physical attacker. Just based on the fact that he learned Fire Fang. Although, I guess Charmeleon learns Fire Fang too. Whatever. Ooh, Electro Ball. That did a lot of damage. But not quite a lot of damage. Alright. Also, opinion on how He's extremely generic, boring rival so far, in my opinion. I really hope something happens with him that's like a big twist, because, like, I don't know. I've been sick of this for 5 generations now, guys. I want a douchey rival again. I'm sorry. These nice rivals are all the same. They're all the same to me. Like, I'm serious. I feel like he has the exact same personality as, like, I don't know, Brendan and May, or, the pointless friends from X and Y. Sharon and Bianca had distinct personalities, in my personal opinion. They weren't amazing or anything, but I could at least say they, with confidence, they had individual personalities that made them characters. Not just, hey, I'm a rival, I'm here to battle. That's what Hao has felt like this whole game. Hey, I'm a rival, here, I'm here to battle. That's it. I hate to say it. I want to show him my best side more. Yeah. Hopefully I end up liking him more, but at the moment, he's a pretty unimpressive rival, in my opinion. That wasn't something I was thinking about in between the last couple episodes. That was just what I thought about now when I was seeing him. That you were tracking down Lily for me? Really? We lost Lily, guys? Really? And we didn't know where she went. Is that really the storyline right now? We lost Lily. Couldn't we have, you know, asked her where she went? Or do we not have phones to call each other in this world? I feel like they should kind of, like, modernize stuff. Fierce Pokemon battles? Back to Icky Town. Wait, we're going back? I don't want to go back! I didn't even fully explore this place! Take on Hala? Okay, guys, I'm kind of confused. I thought they told me there were 7 trials I had to beat before I fought the Kahuna. Or there's just 7 trials in total in the Alola region overall. I thought they said 7 on each island. I could have sworn that's what they said, but I guess I'm wrong because I'm ready to fight Hala now, apparently. So that's a little weird, and I guess Cottonee is pretty common here, so maybe I got lucky by finding Oricorio, which is good, because I really wanted some new things. So back to what I was saying about how I have not had a death yet, and I feel like this game is super easy, other than a few couple times where I got super lucky. So far, I gotta say, I'm sorry, I think this game is pretty easy. I really hope it ups the difficulty later, because pretty much every single trainer I have fought has had only one Pokemon. The only exceptions are a couple, like Hao, or a couple special battles, like the teacher and Illima, who had 2. That's it. I don't remember a single trainer who has had 3 or more. I could be wrong here, just, you know, bad memory, you never know. But I'm serious. I find that very odd, the trainers are only having 1 or 2 Pokemon at all times. I find that kind of silly. Maybe it'll up the difficulty later. Maybe it will. And also, I should not have Stu up front right now. Also, maybe I'm a little bit over-leveled, but I don't know what levels I should be at. This is a blind playthrough. I feel like I should be better safe than sorry. Because I have absolutely no idea what I'm going to be up against. Or what types I'm going to be up against and whatnot. So, like, for example, when I ran into Oricorio, luckily I ran into it in the wild. If I had found a trainer with an Oricorio, I would not know what type it is until I started throwing attacks at it. That's the girlfriend that ran away? Dude, did you try looking over to the left on this cliff over here? Probably not. Is this a ledge? No, it's not. It's a dead end. That's a ledge back to the start. I don't want to go down that way. I wanted to see... My god, the encounter rate in this game is ridiculous! Like, seriously, guys, I swear, the encounter rate in this game is ridiculous. In fact, I'm gonna use a Repel, because I ran into, like, 3 other Pokemon total after I did that cut there. And that grass wasn't even that big. So, I don't know, maybe they... Oh, wait, a sharp beak! I didn't even notice that! Hold on. Although, at the same time, I do have the Normalite on pretty much everybody except... Oh, and I gave the Quick Claw to Microwave, because just so Tenderize could hold a Normalite. I don't know, should I give the sharp beak to Roast? That would just up the power of Peck, but he would not have his Z move anymore. But what Z move does he even have? I feel like he doesn't even have a strong normal. He has Echoed Voice. Yeah, let's give him the Sharp Beak. He uses Peck way more than he uses Echoed Voice. And it's Normalium, not Normalite. I'm thinking it's still on the whole Mega Evolution thing. Oh, what's this? Oh, a photo spot. Do I care? I guess I just see what it is. Oh, it's a cutie fly. Again, there's no way I can tell how to zoom in. I've tried every button. Nothing zooms in. I don't like that. If this is supposed to simulate a camera, this is doing a pretty crappy job. And I can't tell if it's just giving me random compliments or there's an actual strategy to this. I'm on fire? Really? Okay. So in all the pics you can go, let's go to the photo section. Woo! Alright, so what's my best picture of Cutie Fly? I can't even see any of these. Honestly, I think my best one is the one I caught at the end. Yeah, I'm gonna do this one. Photo's been uploaded. Here's the comments. Pedaling, I'm going to bed. Look at your photos. Makes me hungry. Wow. Wow, that was a really crappy photo. No. Okay. I mean, it's a thing in the game. I might as well not pass it up. But at the same time, it's been the most ridiculously pointless thing ever. Unless, like I said, once I get 1,500 points, I get something. Maybe it's an actual item that's helpful in the game. Or maybe it's just like a photo level. It's like, yay, you've taken enough pictures to grow a photo level. Alright, whatever. We're still on Route 3. I wonder if this loops back to Hala. I don't need to use the rappel right now. This is still Route 3. Are you a trainer? No, seeing as you're journeying with the soothe my soul. Oh, you're gonna give me something, though. A soothe bell. Oh. Well, that's nice. I don't really know if anyone evolves by happiness. And hey, there's a TM back there behind rocks I can't break. I really wish I knew how to break these rocks. But I don't. It's not Rock Smash. So here's a rickety bridge. Do you have anything fun to say? Trying to use the red card item. Wait, what? Every last train on Route 3. So there's still more trainers on Route 3. Are there more? Oh, yeah, I haven't fought you yet. Okay. I enjoy the power of my partner, Growlithe. I give it an item to hold. Wow. You're special. No trainer has done that before. I guess most trainers don't. Joshua. Again, one Pokemon. Guys, I'm not crazy here. Every trainer has one Pokemon, except for a select few that use two. Let's see how many Hollow uses. And Scrawl probably has Intimidate. No, he doesn't. Okay. Z-Power. Breakneck Blitz. And also, I gotta admit, the animation for Z-Moves gets old really fast. Because I was, and fun fact, I was actually, when I was doing my training, I turned battle animations off. You still do the little dance before that, but you did it for the battle animations for Z-Moves. But then it doesn't do this part where he flies at the foe for like 10 seconds and then hits him. That part is cut out. So, oh, that's a lot. What item is this guy holding? I'm pretty sure Tackle will finish it off. So, yay! Good job, Rotisserie. Here's your Joshua. Being sure I myself should also have you. What? Did you just say you were? Oh, are you saying you gave Ralph an item, but then you should have used an item to heal? No, that's against the rules, buddy. I'm glad you didn't. But I can use an item outside of battle. Because it'd be silly not to be able to. What's this say? Icky Town? Oh, so this whole route isn't just a shortcut back to Icky Town. There's probably like a ledge to jump down or something. Or you know what? No, I just couldn't go up. Now that I'm thinking about it. As I have, you're shaking my calmer pole. My heart was still water, but no longer. A soul-shaking battle! This seems like it's gonna be harder than normal, but let's try it. It's a good reply. It's a red card user. Alright, well, I know what red card does. It's when you attack a Pokemon holding a red card, it forces you to switch to someone random. It's like getting hit with Roar. Speaking of Roar, I got hit with Roar while I was doing training from a Growlithe, If you are roared by a wild Pokemon in Gen 7, it does not end the battle. It just switches your Pokemon like in a trainer battle. And I really like that, I gotta say. Alright, let's Z-Power Breakneck Blitz. Stealth Rock. Okay, this guy's using some hardcore strats right here. Like, seriously, he's gonna use a red card plus Stealth Rock? That's actually pretty interesting. Maybe I shouldn't have wasted my Z-move on... You know what, then again, I should use my Z-move on just Rotisserie, because she's the one who's gets stabbed from it. She has 150 base power with it, as opposed to just 100 base power that other people have. It is pretty much Breakneck Blitz for pretty much every physical normal attack, is what I've noticed. And there's the red card. Alright, who's he sending out instead? Tenderize, Tenderize, Tenderize! Ah, Stu, okay, that's fine. Well, you're weak to Stealth Rock, so that's not amazing, but... not horrible. Let's give it a Fire Fang. Bite? Oh, that Rockruff's fast. Oh, it's not very effective? Is Rockruff part rock? I thought it was a normal type. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. Then it's super weak to Tenderize. Let's switch to Tenderize. I know it's almost dead, but still. I didn't want to get flinched by Bite or get a critical hit. That would have been too risky. But Anodyne Bite's not very effective. So that's perfect. Oh, let's use Force Palm. I guess I could use Fake Out for a free attack, but eh. Doesn't knock really into matter. Oh, come on! That! Right there! That's exactly what I didn't want to happen to to Stu. Alright, goodbye, Rockruff. Or is Rockruff just rock? I don't know. I haven't used one yet. All I knew is that it existed. But I saw its picture and I was like, oh, that totally looks like an early game normal type. But I haven't found one yet, so maybe they aren't. Alright, well, for this, I'm going to go to Microwave. Because, yeah, Tenderize is not good against that at all. Alright, so here, I had a feeling this guy would have at least two Pokemon, but no, he's got exactly two Pokemon. And you know what? I actually have a feeling this Slowpoke has a red card as well. So, oh my god, come on! Let's use a light screen. Thank you for not hitting yourself, I appreciate it. This should help a little bit. Oh, well, thank you for giving me an thank you for giving me really huge incentive to switch out. Not only am I confused, but I'm gonna fall asleep next turn. But now that I put the light screen up, let's go to Roast. Wow, it feels good being able to switch to every one of my team. Instead of a wedlock, which I did previously on Platinum, which we don't talk about on this channel anymore. I'm kidding. Ah, yeah, that's the power of a light screen. Although, yeah, I guess I didn't think that with the Stealth Rocks did quite a lot of damage to Roast. Oh, well. Take this! And probably you have a red card as well. Yep, had a feeling. So who are you sending out? Rotisserie. Oh, that's fine. That's totally fine, except you're yawning. Well, that's not nice. Well, I didn't even think Pursuit super effective. I didn't even think about that. He's gonna use an attacking move now. I'm gonna actually use Pursuit. I know I'm gonna fall asleep, but... I made it scared, hey. Alright, super effective confusion, yeah. I don't know. I wanna attack it. I don't wanna keep just switching out because I'm afraid I'll fall asleep. Alright, now let's switch out again. I'll probably resist to confusion with Microwave. Unless he uses, like, Water Gun, then I won't resist that, but that's alright. I have a light screen up. That's why I use light screen. So I can have more time. Perfect. Light screen wore off? Well, that's alright. Let's put it up again. I'm not wasting time here. And Quick Claw! Aw, yeah! It's probably gonna use Yawn, to be quite honest. Or just confuse. Okay, it's going straight for confusion. That's fine. I don't know why it's not using Water Gun. That's why it's not using Water Gun. Silly me. Why did I think of that? That's complete and utter crap. And you all know it. Oh, thank you for not hitting yourself. I appreciate that, Microwave. Now, well, yeah. Gee, I wonder why I use confusion and not water gun. Gee, I wonder. Are you freaking kidding me? Okay, I really, really hate this trainer. Alright, guys, so I've learned something. Trainers are either ridiculously stupid easy or pretty freaking hard. I don't know what to do. I seriously don't know what to do. I can't switch out. Too much stealth rock damage is adding up. Thank you for not hitting yourself again, Microwave. I really, really appreciate that. I was just spamming confusion instead of water gun. You know, I wonder if thunder waving it would have helped at all. I thought I would have killed it in two attacks. Thank you for snapping out. Nice job, Microwave. That's how you handle confusion. Wow, perfect. Wow, if I had not snapped out of confusion or, like, got through confusion those couple turns, I think that would have been a lot harder of a battle. So, good job, team. Fantastic job. And it actually felt like a full team instead of pairs. Fine battle. I heard it through clear blue sky. Red card. Okay, now, this red card, is that a one-time use item? Okay, so it sounds to me like there's gonna be trainers like him around. Like, it sounds like they give you, like, a competitive item every time you beat them. And they use that competitive item in battle. So, I appreciate that. That sounds like there are trainers in this game that are difficult. But why are there only a couple far and a few between? I feel like there should be, like, more. You're not a trainer. You told me I beat all the trainers on this route. You're a local. What do you want to tell me? All right. Recall. Oh, you can find him at 10 Carat Hill. I haven't gone there yet. All right. If I happen to catch a Rockruff there, yeah, I'll come show you. Island Challenge Marker. That doesn't help me. All right. We're back on Route 1! Oh, this was conveniently blocked earlier! I remember that. Yeah, I know exactly where we are now. Oh, gladly these guys don't want to battle again. Because I'm really hurt right now. You know what? I don't think there's a Pokemon Center in Icky Town, is there? Please don't battle me right now! Please do not battle me right now. Hala, I really hope I don't battle Hala around. The meme kahuna is strong. Fighting type, so he does not use a Tauros. Okay. Do not fight me yet, Hala, please. I want to heal first. Okay, thank you. I guess I talked to him over there. Meet up with Kahuna Hala. I guess he's around Icky Town. Gee, I wonder where he is, Rotom. Also, Rotom was the other thing I was thinking about between a couple episodes. Maybe I have been a little harsh on him. But my legitimate 100% valid opinion is that the bottom screen of this game is a huge downgrade from previous games. Because it's just a map of the area. Some might say that it's convenient to be able to look around exactly where you are right now. And you know what? Sure. I don't disagree with you. It's not the worst bottom screen of the series. I still think that belongs to Black and White. And Black and White 2, respectively. I personally think, yeah, I think those are the worst. Those are the worst bottom screens. This is probably next in line, though. Because it has very little functionality except just looking down. And then Rotom telling you stuff. Maybe I'm a little, like I said, maybe I'm being a little harsh with him and just saying him to tell him to shut up and that he's annoying. But I don't know. I just don't see a purpose of him telling you that stuff. We can easily figure this stuff out on our own. And you know, I'm thinking, if this is a fighting type trainer, oh, we've got a couple Pokemon weak to fighting. I think I want to start with my own fighting type. Yeah, I have a feeling this is going to be a pretty difficult battle, to be quite honest. Or should I start with Steam, so she could avoid fighting attacks altogether? But I don't know, I'm sure he's got something to counter ghosts. And also, it's probably not enough time to fight him this episode. So, we're gonna just take some. I already talked to you once, I think. Let's check out my PC. I want to look at Oricorio. I want to check Mild Nature, Pound Growl Peck. Oh, that's kind of boring. Ability is Dancer? Not everyone uses a dance move, but it can use a dance move What? So, like, if they use, like, Dragon Dance, or a choreo automatically copies the effects of Dragon Dance? Or, like, Swords Dance? I'm gonna guess that's what that means. That's really, really specific ability, but it's different. Alright, well, it's got plus special attack with mild. It looks like that's higher than attack. I don't know if that's from the nature or that's just a natural thing, so I'll consider using it, but again, like I said, unwritten rule. I don't want to swap out my team unless someone dies. I've got two flying types in the box, don't I? Maybe it wouldn't be the worst idea ever to swap around my team a little bit for this upcoming battle, but that's all right. We'll figure it out. Thank you all for watching today's episode. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you all next time where we battle the big kahuna, Kala, and maybe I'll realize how this region actually works, because I could have sworn they said there were 7 trials on this island. But I guess they meant 7 trials in all of Alola, and I don't know. Maybe I even heard that wrong. But whatever. I mean, maybe they count Kahunahala as a trial, meaning there's like 2 on this island, 2 on another, 2 on another, and then only 1 on the final island. Who knows? Who knows? Thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Rock on.